Welcome back everyone, we are back on Hellblade. Right now we just finished fighting all these huge monsters in teleported to hell or something, and then we had to fight all these weird monsters in there. Right now we are carrying on trying to find our beloved Dill, and from there we will see what we have to complete. So like I said, the game is amazing. Like, the storyline is very complicated, so it's like everything everywhere. It's kind of like a
We're back.
But still, the gameplay is pretty alright. The combat, the actual the story, the words that they pronounce and everything is so cool. It's just everything is everywhere. That's the only mistake they made, I think. They're trying to make it more complicated for us to understand.
Into the mountain. Can you see? Shall we tell her where to go? Come on, look up. Just up there.
So like the voices that we can hear.
Does she know which way to go? Does she know her way into the mountain? She's a girl, isn't she? There's a door. You can do it. You can see it. Go away. I'm not listening.
Let's just go all the way over there and see what's on the end of this bridge. Maybe we might find something or maybe not. So that's where we've been. And then the trees over there. So we kind of... It was kind of weird because we went all the way over there to our tree. Then from the tree we somehow teleported over there. And then we're back in here now, in which we have to go to the mountain. And before the mountain was closed, so now we are, it's probably going to be open. We also gained a new blade. I don't know if you guys have been in that episode, but we have collected a new blade. It's much powerful than the previous one.
I will tell you of a great hero named Sigurd, son of Sigmund, no less. Born after his father's death, Sigurd is cared for by the dwarf, Reyn. But Reyn does not love the boy. Instead, he plans to use him for his own ends. You see, Reyn's father possessed a great treasure given to him by the gods. But Reyn's brother, Fafnir, killed his father and took the gold all for himself. Fafnir hid the treasure out on a heath and could not leave it. And from the evil in his heart, he turned.
She can feel it. No. Don't go in. Turn back.
It's
dangerous.
What's
happening? Get back!
A great beast guards Helheim. Garm is its name. And it knows you are here, Senua. It can smell your stink. What are you afraid of, Senua? How will you save Dillion if you are too much of a coward to step into the shadows?
They can't stop me.
Then do it.
They will walk.
The beast is stalking you from the shadows. Your sword is useless here.
It's me, Senua. It's so loud.
It's not her.
Just so full of hate. I just want to help them. Tell me what to do.
Your father wants them to go away. And he only hurts me to silence them.
But he's gone now.
They always come back. He says I will die if I go with them. They say I'm already dead. want me with them.
Stop!
That's why they crawl through the walls.
Don't
listen. Do you see them?
Do you see their faces? He's coming! Senor! Help me! Help! Get me out of here! Don't go!
Where has she gone? She's disappeared again.
She shouldn't be here. She escaped the darkness. She took her own life to escape it.
She can't remember when it started.
Okay, we have to find the symbols.
When
Let's
her
go.
Mother lost her smile, her eyes gazing past her towards a world she could not see. This is what happens if you reach for the underworld, he said. It was a lot to take in for a child. And the first time she felt the cold chill of fear. I don't talk much about her father, Zimbel. I suppose I just didn't want to risk upsetting her.
Fire.
But it doesn't matter now, does it?
So we are on P.
You killed us. You killed us.
Okay, nice. How is he gonna kill me if there's a fire around me? Nice. So this cave right now is full of light, so you can't get me there. Now we have to go up and see if we can find some more shapes or signs to open the gate.
The dwarf's sole desire is to possess this dragon's accursed treasure, and he uses Sigurd to reclaim it. He tells Sigurd the story of Fafnir's gold, and the good-hearted hero promises to slay the dragon if Rian would forge a strong sword for him. Sigurd remembers that his father once possessed a sword given to him by Odin. Odin broke the sword to bring about Sigmund's death, but Sigurd's mother still has the pieces. And so Rian reforges the famous sword. Sigurd uses the sword first to avenge his father, and then he and Rian go in search of Fafnir.
We will provide light to everything in here. It's like a huge maze around here, you know? let's go in. That's the place we died. Get up.
She's hurt. She's injured. You can do this.
Okay, I'm moving.
She's lighting the torch. It's not gonna help her. She's lighting the torch. Do you hear it? Do you hear it?
Down, look on the floor.
She has it. She did
there
it.
Go.
She's done it. Well done.
This place. It reminds her of the isolating, suffocating darkness that she lived through as a young girl.
This is actually not that hard.
Imprisoned in her room at night. The faces in the dark, coming through the walls. She once thought everyone could see them. That's what children say all the time, isn't it? That there are monsters in the dark. By the time she realized that only she could see them, her father, Zimbel, could see the monster in her.
Oh, forgot that this door is closed. This door is closed. How can I get in there though? There must be some way. No, that's the place I came up. Let's go up now. Okay, now I got my safe checkpoint here. And that's the last one.
Her to trap you in here.
Did you see her die? I don't remember. I was only 5. They told me she escaped the darkness. That she's with the gods. But what if they lied? What if the darkness took her and trapped her here?
Run! You have to go down.
Now it can see you at your weakest. The time you suffered as a child at the hands of your father Zimbo while you pined for Dillion. Do you remember the darkness, Senua? The beast is bringing it back.
Did you leave me? This darkness, it's spreading. Father's keeping me away from the others. Away from Tilly. I won't give up. To rot in here. I'm going to fight them.
Okay, let's go find them then. So we have to go get the torch? Is that right? Because there must be a way to get in there.
The beast is down there.
No. She knows the beast is down there.
I have to be careful so my light doesn't go through. on, matey, let's go.
She's so weak, she's so weak. I can see you're weak.
Too easy. Let's pick up my torch, get the ore. There we go, I knew it. Okay, I get it. Now I have to go around. And then it's gonna show me the symbol R on the floor, probably from the shadow. There we go. Oh, maybe like that. It wasn't really that hard, was it? Come on, open the door. Run. Don't stop, run. She doesn't need to listen, that's the point.
She should have known. She should have. Why doesn't she learn? And she learns. She doesn't understand.
Now the darkness has Dillian's
side. And it will take it and never give it back.
She can.
The dragon Fafnir is so large and deadly that it would be impossible to kill him face to face. But each day, Fafnir crawls across the heath to find water.
Anyways guys, this is going to be it for today. If you did enjoy this video, hit the like button, subscribe to my channel for more videos like this, and I will see you soon. Thanks for watching guys, and peace out. Head,
Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit, and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death, as it led to the death of all the Amir. Sigurd replies that death comes to all men, and every man